like to ask two things. Did you take into account the power that you're putting in?
No.
Because I know that can lead to heating of
Of course. This is why I mentioned that you still have to work on the optimization of the ultrasound application.
Secondly, since you're obviously getting such a high loading ratio,
deloading ratio. Deloading ratio. Oh, loading.
Loading is high. Loading is high and stays high for a long time. And so if it's in the beta phase, an easy way to measure that is also to measure the density of the material. The material's in the expanded condition. The reason I also ask about density is if there's any evidence for a change from the beta phase to a phase that Kukai has observed under high pressure loading of hydrogen, in which there's an order vacancy in every unit cell, so that the crystal structure changes to one of the Kukai structure, in which case the density there would be 25% less than the beta phase.
Well,
the answer is no.
Okay.
Two things they can combine, and you can develop high frequency and a higher amplitude.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I think you should be interested in the easy.
You have used combination of waves. So yes. They will combine in frequency and amplitude, and that may give rise to a certain bias. The pair of atoms or ions have a
position of your electrons. Second, what was the neutron density you have achieved in your experiments? And third, is have you compared the number of melting points you have observed after experiments to the case without supersonic activation? Because there are some other effects can be take place in a similar way.
First one was the palladium composition. Well, it's pure palladium. Pure palladium. I think it's 3/9. Right, Tanya? 3/9. And I'm sorry.
The second was the neutron density.
No, we didn't measure neutron density.
No,
neutron
density.
Neutron. It's asking deuteron density.
Do you have any answer, Tanya? No? No. And the third one is...
melting point.
The melting point. Yes. So, I didn't mention here, but we made... first of all, we found a much high density of those craters using ultrasound compared to without ultrasound. Much more craters. Still, we found some without ultrasound. But we also made a comparison between heavy water and light water. And we found extremely high density of those craters compared to light water. In light water, we couldn't find a crater.
Yes.
I've got three questions. The first one is the attachment point you're using a foil, and how did you attach to the foil cathode, was it attached to the quarter? And then also, where did you take the measurement point? You showed a measurement of high loading long after the loading had been turned off. And where was that measurement taken relative to the attachment point of the cathode for the electrolysis?
But you asked about the wires connected to the foil first?
Yes.
This is a pitch, a point welded. This is the method, and about the loading process from the finishing of the electrolysis loading process to the measurement.
Yes.
So what is the question?
Well, where did you, if the electrolysis attachment was made at one end, where was the loading measurement taken? I think you said you used an X-ray measurement.
Yes, so?
It was in the middle of the coil. Those the ultrasound
ultrasonic energy turned on and left on, or is it just turned on to initiate it?
No, we turn on for several hours each time.
So the electrolysis portion?
The electrolysis continues.
The ultrasonic cavitation continued during the entire excess heat portion, or was the ultrasonic?
We don't measure any excess heat during the operation of the ultrasound. We cannot measure during the ultrasound excitation. So we stopped the ultrasound excitation. We actually operated it for several hours and stopped it and waited for the excess heat.
Thank you.
Microchemical analysis of the service?
Yes. Mark Sillings did the microanalysis of the service. So, what was the question?
Do you find any difference between the original surface and surface after electrolysis?
Well, yes, we found some difference, and we can discuss that afterward. I think that Mark has some pictures of that. Right, Mark?
Could you give us some indications of the way you are measuring the power inputs?
Well, yes. This is a little bit tricky because of the high frequency of the power in when we are using superwave. So we have to make the measurement in high frequency. So we are, the measuring rate is 50,000 times per second. 50,000 times per second we are measuring the current and simultaneously the voltage, and we are multiplying each other 50,000 times in a second.
Which is the
bandwidth? And averaging during 1 minute.
Which is the bandwidth of your... you are using the... what type of apparatus are you using?
What type of
apparatus are you using?
That position system?
Okay. And what is the bandwidth of your measurement?